like the pine trees lining the winding road. I've got a name, I've got a name. Like the singing bird and the croaking toad, I've got a name, I've got a name. And I carry it with me like my daddy did, but I'm living the dream that he kept here.
Moving me down the highway, rolling me down the highway, moving ahead so life won't pass me by.
I was adopted at 3 weeks of age. The story goes they were looking for a son, but my big brown eyes captured my mother's eyes, so I was adopted by them. Kind of moved to America for a couple of years and to Kenya for a couple of years through my father's work, and then basically settled here in Australia when I was about 4 years of age.
Western society is a double-edged sword. It has its brilliant influence, like all things, it's got its negative influences also. But for one, as they say, one man's food is another man's poison. But on the whole, I think it's been very positive. At least my experience with Western culture has been very positive. I've learned a lot from it, and I contribute a lot back to it. So for me, it's been fantastic.
Kids without parents, had they not been here, they might have been a criminal. They might have lawless people, they might have grown into a lawless young man. But here, they get educated, grow up into law-abiding citizens of India, and they learn to help others. Each orphan here helps the other one.
Child has a big problem. Like we had a child who couldn't walk, her whole foot was turned. So we appealed to one of our sponsors in Germany. So they paid for the operation of the child and to get special shoes. So now the child is in standard 2 and absolutely lovely because she can walk, she feels confident. Because our problem is our schools are not on ground floors. They are also up, and many schools don't have lifts. So the child has to have the ability to move.
Yeah, I'd love to adopt. You know, my experience as being the child that was adopted has been great. I came into a really loving family that gave me plenty of opportunities. They allowed me to play every sport under the sun. I did piano, I did jazz ballet, I did tap dancing, I did everything until I found, you know, what I really wanted to do. So the support and love that I got from them, not only at a young age, but also as an adult, you know, has really shaped me. And, you know, I think it's, you know, something that if you're unable to have your own kids or things like that, you know, you can still have a wonderful relationship with, you know, an adopted child.
School jaate ho? Kaun si class mein ho? They are in first standard.
Mm-hmm.
First standard. School से कितने बजे आते हैं?
आठ.
फिर क्या करते हैं यहाँ के? खेलते हैं. They play.
They play.
Yeah.
What do they play?
क्या खेलते हैं? कौन सा खेल खेलते हैं? अच्छा cricket.
Cricket. Cricket. Cricket. Does everyone play cricket?
Yeah.
Everyone plays cricket? Who plays cricket well? Who's a good player?
Raise your hand.
Who's a good player? Oh, everyone's a good player.
But I think to do this, it has to come from within you.
Yeah.
And people today are quite selfish. All me, myself only. Everybody, I, me, myself. You know, no one thinks about the poor people. Yeah. And if you want to say why the gap between the rich and the poor is, it's so difficult to answer that question, because I think the rich become more rich and the poor become more poor. if you want to say why the gap between the rich and the poor is, it's so difficult to answer that question, because I think the rich become more richer and the poor become more poorer.
Yeah.
But nobody wants to seem to help today.
Lisa, someone who's done something quite extraordinary cricketingly, and her background, that she was adopted from an orphanage in India, went to Australia and became successful at cricket, became a captain of another country, it's something that it would inspire a lot of people in a very positive manner. She's a secular citizen of planet Earth, as Duran Duran would say.
I guess maybe I believe in a little bit of fate. I think you are thrown a lot of different things, and yes, you do have to at some point choose to take a certain path, but if you were to look at my circumstances, I'm adopted into a family where my father loves cricket, didn't have a son, kind of threw me out in the backyard and I kind of liked it. He was also a sports psychologist, so he helped me from a young age to kind of get an understanding of my mind and how I can, use that better, not necessarily just purely skills and physical ability. And I think those type of experiences and his help along the way dictated how successful I was going to be at the top level. So I think fate definitely played a role in it.
How much of what occurs is fate? How much is nature? And how much is nurture? Every time Lisa walks out to play, she thinks and acts like an Australian. She plays aggressively to win and to be the best she can be. Her game revolves around what she has grown up with, the influences of her coaches, and the proud history and heritage of cricket in Australia. The difference is that she bats like an Indian. It's not just me that says it either. I know comments are made that she doesn't bat like one of us. If she did, she'd hit it straighter and more over the top. She can't fight nature. For her, batting is a simple task of seeing the ball and working it for runs. Lots of runs. Her Indian wrists help with this. Her wrists she has inherited. Her desire to be as good as she can be, as well as her love of cricket, she gets from her father. Perhaps because it was nurtured in that role, straight out of the orphanage.